Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will not be decoding the editorial. Now the editorial relates to terrorism. I have already decoded editorial about terrorism 2 days ago. Now if you are interested in understanding about this lone wolf attacks, you can watch my previous editorial. So that will be enough and that will be suffice to give you an overview about how this terrorism is undergoing transformation and change. Now for this day, I will be discussing and decoding yesterday's UPSC preliminary paper. Now when it comes to the preliminary paper, we have two papers. One is the GS and another is the CSAT. Now when it comes to the level of difficulty in comparison to the previous year, the difficulty level has seen a kind of jump, but there has not been a phenomenal or a substantive jump, you can say. Now it is important for the 2018 aspirants to know about this year's paper. What is the bifurcation of the various areas in which the questions have been asked for? Now when it comes to the policies and programs, this is the most important area that has been asked in yesterday's paper. Around 32 questions have been asked from this area, 30 to 32 questions about policies, programs of the government. Then when it comes to specifically focusing on the current news that were there, 6 questions have been asked on current news, and about 20 plus questions have been asked on governance, polity and constitution. And when it comes to ecology, environment and science and technology, 15 questions have been asked. And when it comes to the modern history, tentatively 4 to 5 questions have been asked for the modern history. And when it comes to the ancient history, around 2 to 3 questions have been asked. And the most important question that has been asked in the preliminary is about the Jainism. Now this has been the favorite area of the paper setter. Even next year you can expect a question on Jainism and Buddhism. Next year also they will be focused on policies and programs, etc. And next year what I am predicting is that there will be more focus on geography, because when it comes to geography this year, only 10 questions have been asked from this geography portion. So this was about the bifurcation that I've told you about yesterday's preliminary examination. Now if you want to check the key, you can visit IAS Buzz application. We have uploaded the key there, and you can also visit our website BrainyIAS.com. You will find the key on the website as well as on the app. The most important thing now to discuss is about the nature of the questions and how UPSC is tweaking with the nature of the question that it used to ask earlier. Now in comparison to the previous year paper, this paper is more conceptual. Now conceptual here means that you must have a thorough understanding of the questions that the UPSC is asking. It is not only about learning the facts, it is not only about revising the entire syllabus one time or two times. Because if you will be revising this entire syllabus for the preliminary about 4 to 5 times, the end result will be zero. The zero in the sense that you will be just able to score the marks in the range of 90 or in the range of 80s. So that will not lead you anywhere. So if you really want to crack this examination and have a score of about 120 plus, that's the bare minimum I'm talking about. Actually, you should be targeting about 135 or 140. So this is the score that you should be targeting. Now in order to score this score, you need to revise your syllabus n number of times. Now what is this n? N here comes to be around 10 to 15 times. So this is the bare minimum number of revisions that you are required to undergo if you want to crack next year's preliminary examination. And next year's preliminary examination can be cracked only and only if you will start practicing the MCQs. And if you will be understanding the topics from the core, the essence of the topic should be understood. It should not only be about just reading the books. It should not only be about cramming the facts. It should not only be about reading it from the surface. But every topic should be understood. You should know the history, the background of the every topic. That is what is important, and why this current affair is having this particular item of a fact, why this current affair is having this particular type of analysis, how this is linked to the past and how this will be linked to the future. So such kind of understanding is required of the topics. Only the superficial understanding of the topic is not going to help, because UPSC wants such aspirants who have crystal clear clarity about the topics. So now when it comes to the current affair that the students generally refer to, this vision current affairs, this year's vision current affair, it has actually failed. It has only given you 3 to 4 questions in the current affairs. And when it comes to the website that generally people resort to, insights, in that website also you have just got 3 to 4 questions in this year's paper. So what UPSC is focusing on? Now the UPSC want the students to learn the topics from entirety. So you need to focus on the holistic aspect. Now if you will be clear about the holistic aspect, you will be able to infer the answers, and you will be able to infer and develop a sense that this particular answer is right. And if you will not have revised the syllabus nth number of times, and if you would not have developed this quality, the end result is going to be zero. Now when it comes to the specific discussion of the question that has been asked, I will be uploading a new video on the entire question paper of general studies. So this was about the general studies. Now let us also discuss about the CSAT paper. Now when it comes to CSAT paper, the quality has seen a very phenomenal jump. Now very phenomenal jump means that last year a student who was able to attempt 70 plus question, this year is able to just attempt 45, tentatively 45 around questions. So there has been a loss of about 50 questions. So along with the preparation of the general studies, you are also required to focus on the CSAT part, and specifically on the language, reading comprehension, because this year's reading comprehensions, they are quite tough in comparison to that were asked in the previous year. And plus, this year's mathematics portion, the aptitude portion, is also tough in comparison to previous years. So there are no easy questions that used to be asked in the UPSC's, the CSAT papers. So focus on CSAT also next year. So this is a word of wisdom for somebody who will be taking up the preliminary next year. You need also to focus on CSAT. At least devote half an hour a day, or maybe 20 minutes a day on the CSAT portion. That will actually help to develop your aptitude. And along with that, focus on current affairs, policies, programs of the government. Those are really, really important. That is the trend like. So next year, expect more question from geography. Expect more question from science and technology. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.